In this lecture, I will discuss the sampling methods. As you know that there are two types of sampling methods, probability sampling methods and non-probability sampling methods. In this lecture, I will cover non-probability sampling methods. So, dear students, let us see what are the non-probability sampling methods. Convenience sampling, then judgment sampling, quota sampling and snowball sampling method. Dear students, now we shall see what is non-sampling method. In non-sampling method, non-probability sampling method, researcher does not consider the probability of being selected of the sample from the population. Here the intention of the researcher is more important than the probability. Now we shall see the details of non-probability sampling method. Unequal chance of being included in the sample, that is non-random. Non-random or non-probability sampling refers to the sampling process in which the samples are selected for a specific purpose with a predetermined basis of selection. The sample is not a proportion of the population and there is no system in selecting the sample. The selection depends upon the situation. No assurance is given that each item has a chance of being included as a sample. And there is an assumption that there is an even distribution of characteristics within the population, believing that any sample would be representative. Dear students, now we shall discuss different types of non-probability sampling method. As you know, there are four types of non-probability sampling method: convenience sampling, judgment sampling, quota sampling and snowball sampling method. Now we shall start with the first one. Convenience sampling is one of the non-probability sampling methods. Under this method, researcher identifies or draws the sample from the population based on his or her convenience. Dear students, now we shall see an example of convenience sampling method. Startups and NGOs usually conduct convenience sampling at a mall to distribute leaflets of upcoming events or promotion of a cause. They do that by standing at the entrance of the mall and giving out pamphlets randomly. The second method of non-probability sampling methods is the judgmental or judgment sampling. Now in this method, researcher identifies the sample from the population based on his or her judgment or experience. Now we shall see an example of judgment sampling. When researchers want to understand the thought process of people who are interested in studying for their master's degree, the selection criteria will be: are you interested in studying for master's in? And those who respond with a no will be excluded from the sample. The next non-probability sampling method is quota sampling. In this method, researcher identifies the quota or the stratum and ensures that each and every stratum is representative. So in this method, from every quota, by using convenience and judgment sampling method, samples are drawn from the quota or from the strata. In quota sampling, selection of members in this sampling technique happens on basis of a preset standard. In this case, as a sample is formed on basis of a specific attributes, the created sample will have the same attributes that are found in the total population. It is an extremely quick method of collecting samples. The last method of non-probability sampling methods is the snowball sampling method. This is also a non-probability sampling method. Under this method, researchers first identify one or two samples from the population. After that, with the help of one or two, researcher identifies other samples from the population. For example, if researcher is interested to identify the drug addicted people from the students of the university, then researcher can visit the center where they take the medication and then identify one or two, and after that, with the help of those addicted students, researcher can identify others and can draw the samples from the population. There are some comments on sample size which are identified through probability or non-probability sampling methods. The more heterogeneous a population is, the larger the sample needs to be. Depends on topic, frequently it occurs. For probability sampling, the larger the sample size, the better. With non-probability samples, not generalizable regardless, still consider stability of results. Regarding the response rates, about 5 to 10% response rate in mail survey, about 20 to 30% usually return a questionnaire survey. Follow-up techniques could bring it up to about 50%. Still, response rates under 60 to 70% challenge the integrity of the random sample. How the survey is distributed can affect the quality of sampling. Dear students, we have arrived at the last stage of our today's discussion. Today, we discussed in this lecture what is non-probability sampling method, and we also discussed four non-probability sampling methods such as convenience sampling, judgment sampling, quota sampling, and snowball sampling method. We also discussed passed some comments on sample size and response rate. Dear students, I hope this lecture will be useful for you to understand the non-probability sampling methods. Thank you.